In this ongoing lockdown, we are able to stay connected with our friends and family due to telecommunications and internet. We all know very well how the advent of internet connection revolutionized the whole world in so many ways. In fact, you are able to watch this video right now because of internet. Well, this is all possible due to fiber optic technology, a technology that uses glass threads to transmit data. The study of optical fibers is called fiber optics, is also a part of applied science and engineering. A fiber optic cable consists of a bundle of glass threads, each of which is capable of transmitting messages modulated onto light waves. One of the things that helped fiber optics gain its popularity in the business world is its utilization of light signals instead of electrical signals. Light travels down a fiber optic cable by bouncing repeatedly off the walls. Each tiny photon bounces down the pipe like a bobsleigh going down an ice run. Now you might expect a beam of light traveling in a clear glass pipe simply to leak out of the edges. But if light hits glass at a really shallow angle, that is less than 42 degrees, it reflects back in again as though the glass were really a mirror. This phenomenon is called total internal reflection. It is one of the things that keeps light inside the pipe. The other thing that keeps light in the pipe is the structure of the cable, which is made up of two separate parts. The main part of the cable in the middle is called the core, and that's the bit the light travels through. Wrapped around the outside of the core is another layer of glass called the cladding. The cladding's job is to keep the light signals inside the core. It can do this because it is made of a different type of glass to the core. More technically, the cladding has a lower refractive index. If the cladding of the fiber is scratched, it may break. So, a plastic coating called the buffer covers the cladding to protect it. Often, the buffered fiber is put inside an even tougher layer called the jacket. This makes it easy to use the fiber without breaking it. A fiber optic system is similar to the copper wire system. Looking at the components in a fiber optic chain will give a better understanding of how the system works in conjunction with wire-based systems. At one end of the system is a transmitter. This is the place of origin for information coming onto fiber optic lines. The transmitter accepts coded electronic pulse information coming from copper wire. It then processes and translates that information into equivalently coded light pulses. A light-emitting diode or an injection laser diode can be used for generating the light pulses. Using a lens, the light pulses are funneled into the fiber optic medium where they travel down the cable. When fiber optic technology was first introduced in the 1950s, it was prevalently used in the field of medicine. Back then, it was intended to help doctors see the insides of the human body without the need to slice it open. It was not until a decade later when a certified fiber optic technician found out the same technological principle can be used in telecommunications. Ever since that time, fiber optics has been honed further to replace the telecommunication systems that are based on copper wires. There are basically three types of fiber optic cables commonly used. They are single mode, multimode, and plastic optical fiber. Fiber optics has several advantages over traditional metal communication lines. They have a much greater bandwidth than metal cables. This means they can carry more data. They are less susceptible than metal cables to interference and also much thinner and lighter than metal wires. Data can be transmitted digitally rather than analogically. Fiber optic cables have an array of uses that go beyond what most people are aware of. You could have been using them all along and not have even known, like medical industry, communication, defense, industries, broadcasting, lighting and decorations, mechanical inspections, etc.